Improved Path Pattern Guide. In ZW3D 2016, for the roughing operation of three-axis milling, the Improved Path Pattern Guide can make up for many more situations. It becomes easier to use. Let's take this case. This is the product model. First, create a CAM plan and use the default template. Then create a new stock for machining. Click Stock in the Ribbon tab and keep the default parameters. Click OK to hide the stock. Next, create roughing operations. In the 3-axis milling tab, select the offset 2D operation. Then, select the part and stock as features. Then define the machining tool. In the tool manager, input D20R2 as the tool name. And set the radius to 2 and diameter to 20. Click OK. In the following window, click No to modify the parameters. On the primary page, set the surface thickness to 0.5 and Z surface thickness to 0.5 as well. Keep the step-down value as the default. On the Path Setting page, set the Path Pattern Guide to Part Type. Then calculate the tool path. This is the result. Change the model to the top view to see more clearly. Then set the boundary to see more detail at each level. Modify the limiting parameters. Set the top boundary to negative 40 and bottom to negative 45. Then calculate again. This is the result for one level. You can see all tool paths start from the outside, and all the paths are offset from the part boundary. Then, duplicate the operation and blank the first tool path. Next, modify the parameters. On the Path Setting page, change the Path Pattern Guide to Stock Type and set Open Pocket Mode to Any. Then calculate the toolpath. This is the stock pattern result. All paths start from the outside and the inside path is in a wave pattern. Now, hide this path and duplicate the operation to try the third type. Also in Path Setting, set the Path Pattern Guide to the Both type and turn off the Optimize Toolpath option. Click Calculate. This is the result for the Both pattern. The toolpath is offset by the combination of part and stock boundary. Cut from the inside to outside and make a finishing cut along the boundary.